But one is bottled water, one is sewage water. But we're gonna drink, and then we're gonna see, and you're gonna reveal which one is which.
You bet.
I'm pretty confident that this was the bottled water.
Well, that was rigged. It was all poop water.
Ooh, it's Kaminsky. Are you talking about the recent life, like your colleague and the Kardashians?
Today we'll be talking about the poor, the rich, and the people with boatloads of money. To start it off, we're going to be talking about the OG banker himself, Andrew Mellon. Mellon got his chance under the worst president in America, Warren, not an OG Harding. With a businessman's mindset, Mellon wanted to reduce the federal spending and cut the taxes that the rich paid. In 1992, Pro started his political campaign by stating that he wanted the vote of the ordinary people. During his campaign, Perot was pushing to lower federal spending and increase taxes on the wealthy. Trump not only steals hair from other people, he also basically used the same economic policy as Perot. Much like Mellon, Perot and Trump want the government to be run like a business. Carnegie decided to sell his company and devote the rest of his life to charity. This theme shows up in his writings, The Gospel of Wealth. Bill Gates has funded many projects that would help benefit the world, one of which is the funding of a machine that would turn human waste into fresh drinking water. Although the leaders of the companies are still doing well in the world, there are still workers that fall victim to this enterprise. There is some leeway being made, however, a majority of the companies are not changing their views. Without a change in the way the industrial complex works, is the good done by billionaires just empathy for their exploitation of workers? Jake, I will murder you.
I'm scrolling up and down.
I hate this hat so much, just saying. I am right about it.
Gates on it!
You guys, do it.
That's it.